Hi, this is Freddie. I wanted to show you all the harborfreight welder again. Someone asked me if it still worked, and they wanted me to do it some pipe, like for a fence. I guess it's the kind of pipe they use for a fence. It's got a bunch of cement on it, and it's dirty. It's painted black. I'm using that harborfreight portable bandsaw here. I've been using it exclusively to see how long it'll last. Still going. Okay, so here I have the pipe. I just cut it with a bandsaw. I'm not going to bevel it. I'm not going to clean the edges off because if I'm like fixing a fence or something, then I don't want to go through all that trouble for a fence because you just got to hold back a cow, right? Not a tank. Okay, so here I'm tack welding it. This is a 3/32. I'm going to try a 3/32 because that's what the machine recommends, but I don't like the 3/32 for this because it doesn't seem like it has enough juice going through it to penetrate through that paint, through the rust, through that cement, whatever that stuff is. So, but I'm going to try it here just because. Okay, so I'm welding. It's keeping a real like weak arc and it's not penetrating very well. And I have it, it's starting to get good here, but you can hear it penetrating some. I mean, it's all right, but what I really like are the 5/64-inch rods. It won't look that crazy when I take all that slag off, but it's not gonna be a good weld, that's for sure. Okay, here I'm switching to the smaller rod, and as you can see, it's a lot brighter. You can hear it melting in. You can hear it just, you can see it where there's a keyhole there where it's just like melting the sides off, which is good. It means it's penetrating. And this is my practice one right here because gonna come out bad. not terrible, not like it wouldn't work as a fence, but it's not pretty. But you can hear it penetrating, and it's pretty good for a crappy little welder. And I'm not holding the rod straight up and down like I'm supposed to. I have it angled too much. Okay, so here this is right here where you want it. All this over here is too. I didn't tie it in well right there. That was my fault completely. Not too bad. The rest of it's not too bad. It's sticking up a little bit right there. It's a little cold where I started with 3/32. I did another one exclusively with the smaller rod, and I don't know where the rest of the footage went, but here's the end of it. This one came out a lot better, and this one like melted it in, and it's not sticking up too much. And that one came out a lot better. I usually have to do a practice weld before anyway. So see, this one's not too good. That's where I started with that bigger rod. I don't like the bigger rods for this welder. They will work, but I mean, you could clean up all that. If you cleaned it up and beveled it, then you could weld that fence, those two pipes, really well. But I don't think I'd go through that much trouble myself. Okay, so this is a corner clamp from harborfreight. They're very inexpensive. And they're very, you can tell they're expensive because they look very cheap, but I use them a lot. And here I'm going to use the Longevity ArcMate 160D. It's a stick welder like I was just using, but way more powerful than that little box. And it's also a MIG welder, which is great for like, this is some really thin tubing. It'd be hard to stick weld it, especially if there's any gap at all. But with a MIG welder, it's like, MIG welding is the easiest. Once you get the dials set, figure out how to set the dials, it's just the easiest kind of welding. You never get stuck. It's harder to burn through. It's just a lot easier to weld MIG with anything else. Here I'm just dragging it straight across. Like I don't know if I set the machine right. It looks good. I just kind of just eyeball the settings every time and just practice. You can look online. There's some welding charts. This is a little C pattern I'm doing. People do different patterns for different joints and stuff, but this is just a flat. This is the easiest kind of joint you can do flat. There's nothing easier than that. And as you can see, it's like there's nothing to MIG welding once you got it all set up. I have a bunch of spatter here. It could be because of the metal was dirty, had oil on it, or it could be that it's windy because I'm outside. Sometimes a little wind will come. But you can use some like anti-spatter jelly on there if you want, some spray. But you can see the welds are not bad at all. I had a couple more little under ones. That's where they're. I just welding stuff together just for no reason. Okay, someone asked me about filling in on thin sheet metal for like cars and stuff. This is a little technique called buttering in. It's like technically you're not supposed to do it or whatever, but if it's for like car body or some kind of like fixing a rust hole or something, there's like no pressure on it, then that's fine. What I'm doing is just welding the sides, turn the machine lower and let it just hang over and just fill it in, like just fill it in. And after you get it the hole down pretty much, you turn the machine up hotter and just melt it all in. Another way you can do it, the way you should do it, is with a welding spoon. That's like it's a big piece of brass or copper. I don't remember it. I think it's brass. But you put it underneath it, and then when you hit the MIG welder, all that molten metal stays on top of that brass and fills in that hole. But when you pull that spoon down, it doesn't stick to it, so it just stays there. And that's the way you're supposed to do it, but I don't have one of those. So I didn't use it. Okay, so I turned the machine up right now. I'm just going to go back over. I could turn it hotter probably. And I'm just going to go in the middle there and try to melt it all together pretty good. And I stopped there because it started melting through. And I was letting it cool off before I went back in. If you're going to MIG weld some like stuff that's not just for looks, then you know, I'll make some videos about that, like beveling and getting complete penetration and what to look for if it's done right. But for this is like, you're going to grind that off. You're going to smooth it up with a flat disc or whatever, try to get it as smooth as possible, so it doesn't really matter that much. Here I'm just messing around. And thanks for watching.